Excitement in the Parisian air. We're at the Parc des Princes here in the French capital. I'm Derek Ray, and joining me for commentary is the former Arsenal defender, Lee Dixon. And we have pre-season group stage action coming right up for you. It is Chelsea up against Monaco.
Yeah, first game of their pre-season. Time to dust off those cobwebs and start getting the fitness back, Derek. Wouldn't be surprised to see the manager give some of the young players a ride out too. There's definitely a few on the cusp of breaking into the first team.
Pulisic. Jorginho. Chelsea getting the ball forward. What can they do from this position? Well, he was just a fraction offside then.
That's all he needs to be, a fraction. And it was so close.
Conte has lost the ball. And a look at the Chelsea starting 11. Jorginho plays with N'Golo Conte in the centre of the park. And they line up with just the one striker looking to do a bit of damage. Gelson Martins. Plenty of players waiting in the middle. And news of a goal in the Bayern game. Alan McInally can fill us in.
It's a goal for Bayern Munich. 9 minutes played, 1-0.
Regular updates from Alan McInally along the way. Conte. Moving. Surely! Goalkeeping of the very highest order.
Oh, it was a great shot as well. Great shot, great save. Well, that was the chance to take the lead, and the manager's frustration is there for all to see.
Corner kick played over. James has teammates waiting inside the area. Gelson Martins. Well, we know how troublesome he can be on the pitch, but what should we expect from him today, Lee?
Well, pace. Just look how fast he runs. Absolute nightmare for defenders to defend against when the player has that weapon.
Still pushing for that goal that would see them forge ahead. Given away. Conte. N'Golo Conte. And a goal has been scored in the Sassuolo match. Alan McInally.
It's a goal for the home team.
A real opening now. And a goal it is, the opener in this game.
Well, keep it tight, that's what both managers would have been saying. But now the opening goal's gone in. Tactics have got to change. Well, just look at this. They all back off him and he takes the advantage. He goes through one, two, three. In the end, it's a wonderful solo goal.
Well, let's go back to the goal that was scored.
Well, just look at the reactions on the touchline. They just need to keep their composure now. This is far from over.
So, underway once again. Chelsea with the lead in this match. Apologies for interrupting Alan McInally. To confirm, Sassuolo have scored in that game. They now lead by 1-0. Monaco unable to keep it. Pulisic now. Gliding through the gears. Trying his luck from long range. Here's Gelson Martins. Looking for that final pass and for that chance to level the game. No accuracy at all in terms of the shot unleashed.
Well, it's the care and attention, all that work to get in the position and then way, way wide. Well, Derek, the stats tell you everything. Slim pickings out there, not created enough. I can't see them getting back in this game unless their forwards up their game a little bit.
Oh, and a perfect ball now. How about this? And he's in the clear. Rifled against the post, but back in play. And putting his body on the line.
If that went in, this game would have a very different complexion about it, but as it stands, still could go either way.
And news of a goal in the Bayern game, Alan McInally can fill us in.
It's a second goal for Bayern Munich.
He's got to score! Not the easiest of situations for the keeper. And Chelsea win the corner. He's driven in the corner. And Pulisic has it. Can he put it away? And Chelsea have done it! It's going to be so difficult to stop them now.
As we can see, right place at the right time. Striker's instinct is to be there or thereabouts. Keeper has no chance.
So 2-0 now. Diop. We've been waiting to find out, now we know, a minimum of 3 added minutes here, and that's an important intervention. Promising sequence, and he stopped them in their tracks. And so the half-time whistle has gone here at the Parc des Princes in Paris. Well, there's a good reason why we're highlighting him. He's really dominating in attack. So here we go, the start of the second half at the home of PSG, the Parc des Princes. Given away. You know, Chelsea have an awful lot of space. Not a cross that will live long in the memory. Goal kick. N'Golo Conte. Fruitful looking attack. Well, they did have the ball, but not anymore. Here's Kovacic. And he's beat, surely! Well, the post getting in the way there. And he's made it a brace for himself. The defender's just unable to stay with him. And he's having a field day.
Well, it's good build-up, and there's one player standing in front of the goal. And it falls to him, and he's not going to miss from there.
Well, the goal again, albeit from a different angle. Well, sadly, we have to conclude that this hasn't really been a contest, but all credit to any side committed to scoring goals like this. Here's Kovacic. Well, they were clearly on the receiving end, so a free kick is next. And a substitution in the offing. Well, that's very smart defending, and now they have the ball again. Space on the flank. And in with a real chance. Splendid save from the keeper, danger averted.
Yeah, he didn't have long to react to that, but you have to praise his reflexes there.
Well, they have elected to go to the bench at this stage of the game. Corner again. The corner played into the box. Not really the ideal clearance. And news of a goal in the Bayern game. Alan McInally can fill us in.
It's a third goal for Bayern Munich. It's been scored by Thomas Muller. An easy poke home from close range after a shot was deflected. 64 minutes played, 3-0.
Alan McAnally keeping us right up to date. Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now fisted clear. And breaking at pace with menace. Can he make it count? I don't think the goalkeeper will be complaining about poor finishing like that, Lee.
No, it's not about the goalkeeper, it's about that poor effort. That really is awful.
Conte. Willian. Willian has teammates waiting inside the area, and they deal with the threat this time. Favre. Diop. Just been a thoroughly cogent and convincing performance in this match, Lee.
Well, creating goals is hard enough, but the scoring of goals is the hardest thing to do in football. Chelsea, for me, have ticked all the boxes in that department for me. They've been lovely to watch. And look at all the players. They've all got smiles on their faces. We love to see that.
I believe there's been a goal in the Bayern match. Let's hear all about it from Alan McAnally.
It's another goal for Bayern Munich. It's been scored by Robert Lewandowski.
Can they convert? Well, he knows he can do a lot better on the shooting front.
Well, how many times has he had that chance in training and scored on that occasion all over the place?
Aguilar. Favre. Giving them the gift of possession. Well, apologies to Alan McAnally for having to cut him off in that fashion. To clarify, Bayern have scored in that match, and they are very much in the driving seat, winning 4-0. Inside the final 5 minutes now. Well, they were clearly on the receiving end, so a free kick is next. They will now make use of their substitutes bench. There's a thorough understanding of defending, Azpilicueta. Garavin. The referee's verdict is 3 additional minutes. They've regained possession. Chelsea finding forward gears. Can they take advantage of this promising position? Real chance. The goals keep going in for them. I don't think they're going to throw this away now. Absolutely omnipotent.
Well, just look at this. They all back off him and he takes the advantage. He goes through 1, 2, 3. In the end, it's a wonderful solo goal.
Well, the goal again, albeit from a different angle. Well, if there were any lingering doubts about the outcome, surely they now have been removed. And there goes the final whistle. Well, certain things came off for him in this game, but not everything, Lee.
Give me back, give me that beautiness. Great to have you along with us at the Parc des Princes in Paris on such a splendid day too. Alan Smith alongside me, Martin Tyler. We're in pre-season tournament action for you. It's a second group stage game. It's Leipzig against Chelsea.
Looking forward to seeing some of the younger players in these two squads. The manager's giving them a run out as they try different shapes, formations, early days in terms of this season, a long season ahead.
Nice to be back here, Alan. We spent quite a lot of time during the European Championships in 2016 in the Parc des Princes, and it's got lovely facilities for we broadcasters.
Yeah, definitely. Gives us a good view, and it always brings back memories of when I played here, going right back to 1994, semi-final of the Cup Winners' Cup.
It's a good pass in behind the defenders. He did well to reach it, but he couldn't keep it. Going to be a throw right by the corner flag.
It's all about concentration this game, and the keeper showed plenty of that just a few seconds ago with a stunning stop, didn't he?
That's a decent header, but not quite good enough.
Well, they've got to get tighter to him because he's a really good header of the ball. He showed it there.
Leipzig's lineup is this. Well, we put it up. And what looks, Alan, very defensive, but there's flexibility, isn't there, in the side?
Yeah, and I think with his shape, so much depends on the wing-backs, how much they are allowed to get forward and what they can do when they do get forward.
The player's done well here until it was the direction of the pass, really. Right idea, but couldn't find his man. It's out over the touchline. Goal news for you from Lyon, from Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Lyon. 8 minutes played. 1-0.
We're back here again, thanks to Alan McAnally. Tight call, and he's made it, the flag's up.
Some relieved faces amongst those defenders there. I think they thought the flag was going to stay down.
Here's the Chelsea lineup. 4-3-3. And they've got natural wide players in that front three with a central striker.
I think that's the key, because those lads on the flanks, it's quite a complicated job, actually, because they've got to come inside, support the centre-forward, and they've also got to funnel back when they haven't got the ball. So.
Chance now to go ahead. Just cleared downfield, not a proper pass, because the pressure is so intense. And that's a turnover to the opposition. Amadou Haidara, Lima. Under some pressure, he shielded it well. Conte. Well, that pass never looked like reaching its target, and they're away with the ball. Werner. Saw it coming, cut it out, good work. Goal news for you from the Atalanta game from Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Atalanta. 27 minutes played, 1-0.
That's Alan McAnally. A great chance to go in front. It's come off the goalkeeper, still in play. Dealt with the danger. A chance maybe to hit the target. He certainly went for strength.
Nothing wrong with the connection either.
Kevin Campbell, quick-witted and quick in his movement too to intercept there. Conte with Jorginho. The build-up is patient. They could go in front here.
Not the easiest of managers to work for, I know that,
but his players are doing what he demanded beforehand now.
Chelsea are ahead now. Yeah, my apologies for interrupting Alan McInally earlier. I would never dream of doing it normally, but we had to do it today. He was giving us the information that Atalanta have scored. The score is now 1-0. Our man Alan McInally is watching the Atalanta game. We bring him in here because there's been a goal for Alan to bring us right up to date about.
It's a goal for Porto. 37 minutes played. 1-1.
Well, right on the spot there for that story. Alan McInally, of course. Now the cross has gone behind. It's a poor effort. We can have another look at that very important match-leading goal. Now James. Conte. I think he saw the look from the other player and saw where the pass was going and read it. Werner. Very good challenge. They can be quick on the break now. Opening them up with a through pass. It's broken down. And so it's 1-0 here as the half-time whistle goes. Played well in the first half, Chelsea. They've got this half-time lead. Well, here he goes. It's good to see a player do this. Ilsanka, Nordi Mukiel. Very hard for the defending team to do anything with the ball in these circumstances. I think that's a good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in the first half?
Well, he played really well, didn't he? And he got himself a goal to put his team ahead. He'll be pleased with that first 45 minutes.
Kovacic. Opportunity! Just a reminder of what a great keeper he is.
And he's a big lad, and he needed every inch of his frame there.
He's put in the corner. It was a promising situation. They could have made more of that. Got some strength, hasn't he, to shield the ball like that. That's a great interception. Probing pass. Willian. It's a good cross. The crossing is a skill, and that's not a very good example of it. They've spoilt the promise of that attack. Well, long overdue, you feel, this change. The side that's behind, a switch of tactics now. Bit of pressure on the player, that's why it's gone out. Bit of noise about the movements of Cesar Azpilicueta. Possible Azpilicueta could be on his way to Borussia Dortmund.
Well, they do say there's no smoke without fire, and I wouldn't be at all surprised to see this one go through. About 30 million, they say. What will Chelsea say to that?
Slipping it through. He's in. The goal is there for the taking. And they have scored. And they do lead now by two. And they've worked very hard for this. It should get them across the line at the end of the match. We'll see. Excellent for his team. Easy for him.
Well, he's laughing and joking about it because it was perhaps the easiest goal he's ever scored in his career.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. He's won it back easily. Time for a substitution. Penalty at Atalanta.
It's a penalty for Porto. He's put the ball down on the spot. Up he steps. Oh, nice one. Oh, he's hit the post and it's gone back out the way. It's missed. 68 minutes played. It remains 1-1.
Great to have Alan McInally out and about for us. And he's brought us right up to date again there.
Chelsea seen more than enough of the ball. No wonder they're winning. Sometimes you can have the ball and
not be able to do anything with it, but this side have been quite the opposite. So creative and so clinical so far.
Goal news for you from the Atalanta game from Alan McInally.
It's the second goal for Atalanta. 74 minutes played, 2-1.
That's Alan McInally guiding it through.
It's offside.
Well, they're still trailing and they need to do something now if they want to get back into this game. Maybe some fresh legs will do the trick.
Well, apologies for interrupting Alan McInally there.
That's confirmation for you that Atalanta did score in that game. The scoreline in that game is now 2-1.
Part of the game, the use of the substitutes, very important part of the tactics too. We've got to change.
Trying to slip it through. Conte.
Got to be.
And turned away by the goalkeeper spectacularly.
Corner's taken. Solid punch by the goalkeeper. Goalkeeper makes a save. That's a comfortable save.
Goal news for you from Lyon, from Alan McInally.
It's a third goal for Lyon. 6 minutes remain. 3-0.
Cheers, Alan. Kevin Campbell. Well, now they've got the ball, what are they going to do with it?
Come back to get a touch and get involved in the game.
Now the shot! Keeper called into action and ready for it. Some activity on the Chelsea bench. Here comes the corner. Lillian.
Referee's had a good look and decided from what he's seen from this period of play to add on 3 minutes.
Werner. Difficult for the defender against the player who wants to take him on like this. Saw the pass coming and got there first. And it's come to an end now as the referee calls a halt. I guess the opposition will feel that they could have maybe shown a bit more punch, but...
Everyone roll through. Don't matter where I go, as long as I go with you.